It is safe to say that Rick Stein has the best job in the world. During his long career, the award-winning foodie has crisscrossed the planet, combining his love of travel with his passion for cooking. His latest food odyssey took him from Venice to Istanbul, and Rick Stein joins us now. What a dramatic entrance! How are you?
Very,
welcome
very, very
to
well.
The show. Gee, food and travel. Hey,
I know, it's
what a combination.
I know. I keep trying to say to people, look, we do have to work. You know, it is making TV.
Someone has to do it.
I know. But, no, it is quite special. I can't lie to you. It is quite special.
And your specialty, really, what you're known for, is your seafood.
Yes, yes. This looks nice. Do you want me to comment on it?
Yes, I do.
Well,
when did this love affair start?
It's funny because I've got this restaurant down in Mollymook. And the reason I took it over was because it so reminded me of Padstow. Mm. And what I...
And of course, Mollymook is on the south coast of New South Wales for visitors and viewers in other states.
It's just because
of
Padstow, I would just... And childhood in Padstow, I just had... I've always had such a great enthusiasm for seafood. So to come here, go on holidays with my wife, Sarah, in Mollymook, and realise that there was a sort of almost like a parallel wonderful seafood to Padstow, I just had to do a restaurant.
So where's Padstow?
It's in Cornwall.
Just thought I'd establish that for
That's
anyone
a good
that was
point,
curious.
Actually, not in Sydney, which I've been to the one in Sydney, and there's a restaurant called the Seafood Restaurant in.
Okay, well, is the seafood feature in your new book and television show, which is Venice to Istanbul, I think?
Yes, it does. I mean, there's lots of other food in it, and but it is the biggest chapter. But then there's lots of. There it is.
So would the recipes that you've got in this book, then, for given if it's Turkey and Istanbul, do they have lots of spices?
They do, actually. And one of the things that the thread through a lot of the recipes in the book, Venice to Istanbul, was the sort of spice, the evidence of spice everywhere. Not like India, or not really, really strong, but a sort of subtlety of things like nutmeg, cinnamon, cloves, coriander. That, I think, sort of joins a lot of the cooking in that part of the world together, really.
But isn't your favourite recipe a chicken dish?
You laid that one very sort of like that.
Oh, no, I love seafood, but I just know that you're quite a hand with
Well,
chicken.
I mean, I've got a number of favourite seafood dishes in the book, but this one... The reason I've chosen this one is because it's very Turkish. It's got sumac in it, which was this fabulous sort of lemony spice. Mm. And it's slightly hot with a bit of chili, a bit of Aleppo pepper in it. But it's really easy to make. So I sort of chose it slightly because I know people will make it. Indeed, we've started...
And it's in the book.
It's in the book, yeah.
It's in the book. Now
I just call it sumac chicken, but the recipe's, the title's a bit longer.
I thought you were talking about tuna, which is the chicken of the sea, isn't it?
Yes, there you go.
Hey, people get a bit nervous when dealing with seafood because it can be tricky buying the right kind and making sure it's fresh. What sort of tips do you have for us?
Well, I think first and foremost is just trust your instincts, and that's a really stupid thing to say, I know, because if you're not that familiar with fish, what are your instincts?
Yes.
Well, they're there. In a human being.
If it doesn't smell right?
If it doesn't smell right, if it doesn't look firm and shiny and colourful, it's probably not going to be fresh. And what I always say is, if you're going into a fishmonger's, into a fish shop, use a comparison, because it's like when you're tasting wine. If you don't know that much about wine, it's much better to taste one wine against another to get a test on which is nicer, and then you can start forming opinions as to why it's nicer. The same with the fish.
The eye tells you a lot.
The eye tells you a great deal, because in these two snapper, they're very sort of lustrous. Mm-hmm. I often say, if you look into the eye, you can almost see the bottom of the deep blue sea through them if they're clear like that.
And how long can you keep fish in the fridge?
I am a fish. You know.
How long can you keep fish in the fridge? Now, I'm asking you this for personal reasons. I know you're going to know, but I bought some fish on the weekend.
Yeah.
And barramundi fillets, and I meant to put it in the freezer, and I forgot. And I looked at it this morning. I thought, oh my God, the fish is still here. I'll have to cook it tonight. Is it still all right?
Yes, it would be. I mean, a lot. a lot depends on how fresh the fish is when you buy it, of course. And it's not, if you can use it the same day, it's yes. really the best. It doesn't, it's really hard to keep it.
So for pongs, it mightn't be good.
Yeah, no, I think, honestly, I think your nose is the best bet with fish. And unfortunately, a lot of the times, because of health and safety and all that, you can't actually lean over in a fish counter and start to smell stuff. But...
Well, this is very fresh because, fortunately, here in Sydney, Studio 10 and Channel 10 is right opposite the fish markets.
Well, honestly, Ida, when I look at this, I know. Now, why do I know? That's a good point. Well, A, I said because of the shine on that, as you pointed out, the eyes. And I'd also like to have a look in the... of course, I won't be able to get in there. Look at the gills. The camera's Ooh, not in there
lift
tight
it up
enough,
a little
but
bit.
Yeah, do.
There we go.
But that's a lovely pink. And as
oh,
they, as,
yeah.
Oh yeah, there you go. As fish stales, so those gills get more and more brown and sort of, you know, not very nice. Oh, wonderful.
Well, Rick, we will put all of your food, your seafood tips on our Facebook page so people
oh,
can
good.
Have a little bit more confidence
well,
when buying
I'm
fish.
Flattered.
And of course, Rick's latest book, From Venice to Istanbul, is in bookstores now. Great recipes. Thanks for coming in.
Great tip. Thank you.